The very warmest of welcomes to you indeed to the Lausitz Arena in Cottbus, Germany, and the second day of finals action at the World Cup of Artistic Gymnastics apparatus qualification for Paris 2024. It's the order of business, and it's a complicated business too. This is the second of four World Cup events. So many nations have entered this. The field is packed with aspiring Olympians. Some of them have been there already. Some of them have competed in Tokyo, in Rio. Some of them have competed way, way back before that. Others dream of it for the very first time. Some of these athletes that you're about to see have already secured a place at the Olympiad, either through their teams, of which they are likely or very hopeful at least to be part of, or they've directly secured their own spot, a named spot that is theirs and theirs alone. Others are hoping that this will be their day, that this will be their year, that they will have calls to dance and to celebrate,
and to be able to say that they were part of Paris 2024. Und heute wird es sein beim Herrn Sprung, Barren und Reck und bei den Damen Boden und Balken. Und das heißt, die Geräte sind freigegeben. Wir können gleich loslegen, aber vorher möchte ich Ihnen noch zwei Leute vorstellen, die mit mir gemeinsam kommentieren, was wir in der Halle zu sehen bekommen. Ich weiß, Sie sind ein sehr fachmännisches und fachfreudiges Publikum heute in der Lausitz Arena gewohnheitsmäßig, aber Sie sind trotzdem zwei Meister, mehrfache Meister und internationale Erfahrung gesammelt an Geräten und natürlich auch am Mikrofon. Und ich bedanke mich und begrüße ganz herzlich Kim Bui.
There is somebody who's competed at the Olympic Games on several occasions.
Ich werde auch gleich dort oben hinwechseln, aber vorher darf ich noch sagen, viel Spaß beim 47. Turnier der Meister in Cottbus und bitte die ersten Turnerinnen und Turner in die Halle.
And without further ado, we begin the first of five finals coming your way over the next few hours. We have the men's vault and women's balance beam competitions first. And then we'll move on to the men's parallel bars and women's floor exercise and finish with the men's horizontal bar.
Und wir beginnen bei den Herren beim Sprung und bei den Damen beim Balken. Und wir beginnen bei der Vorstellung der Damen für China, George Ta Qin.
Joy Yachin of the People's Republic of China, top qualifier in the balance beam
Uehara
competition.
Ashikawa.
Silver medalist at the World Championships. And there is a world champion from 2021, Ashikawa Urara. Jennifer Williams of Sweden, the sixth best in qualification. Belgium's Erica Pingston, who won the silver medal in Cairo. And her international teammate, but competitor today, Nina Derweil, who won the gold medal in Cairo. We have the uneven bars champion from yesterday, Kelia Nemour, second best in qualification for this final. Laura Casabuena of Spain, the eighth best in qualification, Mediterranean Games finalist on beam. Nakamura Haruka, the reigning junior all-around world champion and the Asian champion to boot. Over to the men's vault, and Harry Hepworth, who beat the Olympic champion on floor yesterday. He's the sixth best qualifier in this final. Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan, Asian Games medalist on vault. Chun Yilu of the People's Republic of China, silver medalist at the National Games and the national champion last year, or the year before last. Mariol Fati of Iran, who's already been a World Cup medalist in Cottbus. James Bakweti of Australia, Commonwealth Games medalist on vault. Sengwei Sheng of Chinese Taipei, World University Games silver medalist last year. The reigning champion of the world, or the champion of the world, I should say, from 2022, Arta Davtian. He was sixth at the last World Championships and was a medalist at the Olympic Games. And Igor Sharamkov, individual neutral athlete. I apologize if you're getting some disruption to your pictures at the moment. So those of you who are German speakers, you can hear in the arena the voice of Kim Bui, and you'll also hear the voice of Ronny Zeitzma, member of the national team, former member of the national team. These are the finalists in the men's vault competition. Harry Hepworth of Great Britain will get things underway. The top performer in qualification, Arta Davtyan, not a surprise. The Armenian will go second to last. The balance beam finalists, top qualifier Zhou Yachin of the People's Republic of China will get things underway. She was the silver medalist at the World Championships last year. Ashikawa Urara of Japan will go after her, the world champion from 2021. As the warm-ups are taking place, just a moment to remind you that this is a pathway to Paris 2024. There are two slots available in each apparatus, and they are decided at the end of all four of the World Cup events. Cairo has already taken place. We'll refer to performances from Cairo as we go through and look at the athletes individually. Baku and Doha are to come. After Doha, we will have clarification of the full list of qualifiers. Now, there are some caveats, some ifs, buts and maybes. For example, on balance beam, it's a very interesting picture from a Belgian perspective, because after the first World Cup event in Cairo, Belgium were 1 and 2. You think that would be very good news for them. It is, but only half good news, because only one athlete per nation can qualify from each apparatus. So Nina Derwal is leading the way, Erica Pinkston in second place. But that second place is immaterial if you've got a member of your own national team ahead of you. Added to that, not every gymnast here is attempting qualification for Paris 2024. Some are part of teams that have qualified and they can't earn an extra individual place. That's different from the previous Olympic qualification process, as the team size is a little larger than it was back in Tokyo. He's one who's in that position, Harry Hepworth. Other gymnasts, like the next that you'll see on vault, Milad Karimi, he's already secured a place at the Olympic Games through the World Championship all-around qualification. So different situations for different athletes, and I'll endeavour to keep you up to date with it as we go through the competition. And let's get things underway. Zhou Yachin of the People's Republic of China on beam. Top performer in qualification. Silver medalist at the last World Championships. Very nice walk over into the front tuck, and then keeping the routine going with an attempt to earn some connection bonuses. Purposeful height in the leap. Small adjustment as she landed, but quite minimal. It's a very difficult routine. There's 6.5 in qualification. The most difficult of any of the qualifiers. What a super piece of gymnastics from Zhu Yaqin of the People's Republic of China, commanding on the apparatus, the 18-year-old. Her first overseas competition as a senior was the World Championships last year, where she made it onto the podium. Lovely, symmetrical, tight tuck position. Gets the legs up to horizontal. Isn't that polished-looking gymnastics? Little features like the toe point before she embarks upon the free walkover. Flicking up the back leg to try to get it to head level or beyond. Again, the toe point in the Corbett flip. It's all rather nice. And the twisting, she gets fully round at the end. Well, this ought to do rather well indeed. She has been the national champion and the national games winner on beam. She's from Henyang, the second largest city in Hunan province in the south of China. We are going to see her on floor later, where she's also the top qualifier, and she's the reigning Chinese champion on floor. And the difficulty is up to 6.7 by 2/10 from qualification. She's gained over a third of a mark. Brilliant. Now we go to Harry Hepworth of Great Britain on vault, sixth best in qualification. He was the runner-up on vault at the National Championships last year. A good-looking Dragulescu to begin. Nice central line. His vaulting has got so much more secure in the last year or so. He must be as high as a kite after that result yesterday in the floor final. Powerful. Coming out of the tuck position to put that half twist in. Good judgment. How will that compare to the execution in qualification, which was 8.9? I think this is going to be a very engrossing men's vault final, actually. ...14.9 for Harry Hepworth. He's well up from qualification by 4/10 of a mark. Indicating a yo after Yo Hongchul. Second vault. Always a little low there, Harry Hepworth. And he does well to keep it as vertical as possible. Interesting, that was the stronger vault, the second one in qualification. It won't be the case this time. But that is great strength in the lower body shown to actually avoid concession of a full mark. He shakes the head, doesn't he? All elite athletes know better than we will ever know when it doesn't feel quite right. They don't need telling. So 2 5.6 difficulty vaults, 14.733 for Harry Hepworth. I'll just bring you the aggregate score in a moment. We go now to Ashikawa Urara on B, the world champion from Kitakyushu in 2021. Ashikawa Urara is part of a Japanese team that has already qualified for the Olympiad. Same for Joya Chin. Different circumstances for Ashikawa than the qualification process for Tokyo, where she actually was the top performer on beam. Made it to the games, made it to the beam final. Very enjoyable beam final after these first two performances. Ashikawa Urara, following in the footsteps of Joya Chin. Her execution in qualification was 7.7. It was the second lowest of all of the qualifiers. This looked perhaps a more authoritative display. The tidiest form, twisting round at the end, a little crossing over of the legs, but it was well performed.
Mai, this is your applause.
That's lovely, isn't it? Recognition for an absolutely super gymnast, Murakami Mai. From one veteran to another, because the honours were done by Kim Bui. 14.2. So she's well up from qualification, goes into second place. Now, just to come back to Harry Hepworth, 14.566 was his second vault. The 14.733 was the aggregate score. Now we go to Milad Karimi of Kazakhstan. Bronze medalist at the Asian Games and the World University Games on this apparatus, and already qualified for the Olympiad. Not the most secure Dragulescu there from 24-year-old Milad Karimi, but we just remind ourselves he's in a different position from everyone else. He's got that place locked in by virtue of his all-around display in Antwerp. He's quite jackknifed as he lands. And again, he actually does well to stabilise the vault quickly. .5 for the first vault from Karimi. He's down by 0.2 from qualification. Yeah. Should point out that it is something of an upgrade for Karimi to be working on that Dragulescu vault. Oh, he's a little out of position, isn't he, on that Kasamatsu with 1.5 twists. Not the tidiest of vault finals from Kazakhstan's Milad Karimi, but again, just reflecting on the fact that he, for quite a while, used to post 2 5.2 difficulty vaults. Aroche was, if my memory serves me correctly, a first vault for him for a while. He's gone back now to trying to refine that Dragulescu. And that could be not so much of great value to him from a vaulting perspective, but from an all-around perspective at the Olympic Games, to have a 5.6 vaulting score, because really, if one is to be competitive, really competitive in the all-around competition, then a 5.6 difficulty vault is pretty much a must. So 14.05 is his total score. .6 for the second vault. Jennifer Williams of Sweden, 3 times a Nordic junior champion, now takes to the beam. She was the 6th best in qualification with 13.333. Didn't make any finals in Cairo. Is not part of a team that has qualified for the Olympic Games. Was performed with real grace. Good save. Lovely snap coming out of that front walkover. It was performed with authority. Oh, nearly. Difficulties right at the end on the dismount for Jennifer Williams. She's a very engaging gymnast, isn't she? There's a certain finesse to a lot of what she does. She's still only 18. We have not had the chance to see a lot of her internationally of late. As though she was going to be on course to land that. Really did. Did so well, didn't she, at the World Championships in Kitakyushu in 2021, finishing 23rd. Best Swedish performance in the all-round final since Veronica Wagner in 2009. It was a long time coming. Yeah. going to wait for the score for Sweden's Jennifer Williams, and it is in now as 11.733, and that is down by over a mark and a half, unfortunately, from qualification. Chen Yilu of the People's Republic of China, the 2022 national champion. He's 26 now. Not somebody that we get to see a great deal at international level. And that is very unusual and very impressive vaulting. The travel that he got away from the apparatus was so strong. Chen Yilu, he was the fourth best in qualification with 14.516. Well, it's quite extraordinary. It's a bold piece of vaulting, a round off, half on, and then front layout position with 2.5 twists. Vault associated with Li Xiaopeng. And his score is a very, very impressive 15. Now to the second vault for Chen Yilu. He's up by over 0.2 from qualification. Indicating that he's going to perform Eric Lopez's eponymous vault. And he does, slightly splayed position as he lands. Not perhaps as secure looking as that first vault. This is the slightly less difficult of the two vaults, 5.6. That first vault, the Lee vault, is a 5.8. It's a rare 5.8. We don't see many of them. Generally speaking, towards the top end of men's competition, you see either 5.6s or 6.0s from the very highest difficulty vaulter. So it's interesting to see an intermediary 5.8 difficulty score. Nice one there for all of you who are obscure vault spotters. 14.85 is the average for Chen Yilu. He's up by over 0.3 from qualification, goes into the lead. To Erica Pinkston of Belgium. The gymnast who, I was about to say the gymnast who was the runner-up in Cairo. The 16-year-old having a very tough mount sequence. Oh no. We just remind ourselves that these World Cup qualification events are decided on the best 3 of 4. That is if the gymnast enters all four. Steadied the ship here. Well done to young Erica Pinkston. after a very tough beginning, we got to see just what she's made of, Erica Pinkston. That was determined from the young athlete from Hasselt in Belgium. She made her senior international debut in Germany at a competition called the DTB Pokal in Stuttgart. That was last year. And her World Cup debut was in Cairo last year as well. We just remind ourselves that Joya Chin and Ashikawa Urara are slightly red herrings in terms of the Olympic qualification standings, in terms of this leaderboard, because they are part of teams that are already qualified and therefore cannot earn a spot.
Aber wenn wir schon in der Quali drüber gesprochen, Biken, 10 cm breit, den müssen wir erstmal treffen. Oh, da gibt es noch die Geburtstagsbücher.
10.133 for Erica Pinkston.
Ja, sie hatte natürlich gehofft, hier wertvolle Weltcup-Ranglistenpunkte zu bekommen.
Just point out, by the way, I said she was 16. It was actually her 17th birthday yesterday. Mahdi Olfati of the Islamic Republic of Iran. Oh, that was powerful. Good start for the second strongest in qualification. 15.033 was his average. Difficult to come out of the pike position and judge your landing. But he does do that well. Obviously carrying a little knee trouble into this competition. 22, Mahdi Olfati from Gorgan in the far north of Iran, close to the Caspian Sea. It used to be an independent Zoroastrian state during the Persian conquest of Iran. 15 is his score. ...14.9 was the score for this second vault in qualification. Yes, he's done well. He's done really well. So two double pike vaults from him. Yurchenko double pike first after Yang Wei, followed by another vault named after a Chinese gymnast, Lu Yufu. Tsukahara double pike. Both 5.6 difficulty, and both performed successfully by the youngster. And he really needs a strong display here, Mahdi Olfati. He was fifth in Cairo, 14.9. has sent him into the lead. For the second vault. So Olfati, the Iranian, just ahead by 0.05 over Chenilu. Then it's Harry Hepworth, then it's Milad Karimi. But we just remind ourselves of the four that we've seen. Only Mahdi Olfati is directly bidding for Olympic qualification, because Hepworth's part of a team that's qualified, Karimi's got his own spot, and Chun is part of a team that's qualified. So that's a crucial display from Mahdi Olfati. He's put himself into a very fine position there. He's got to contend with Igor Sharamkov, James Bakweti and Tsengwei Sheikh. So some very good vaulters to come. Over on the balance beam, Joy Yachin ahead by almost 3/4 of a mark over Ashikawa Urara. We have to come next, Nina Derval, who won in Cairo and is going for Olympic qualification. We have also Kelly Moore, Laura Casabuena, and the excitement of seeing a new senior in Nakamura Haruka last in this beam final. Young fans watching on, I wonder how many of them are aware of the significance of this in the lives of these gymnasts. I wonder how many of any of the crowd of all ages watching on is really fully aware of the intricacy of Olympic qualification. In a sport like gymnastics, it's always going to be tricky. It's always going to be difficult to leave sufficient pathways open to every athlete so that the specialists can qualify, the all-arounders can qualify, the great teams can qualify, because ultimately more miss out than make it. It's an Olympiad, and when the Olympic Games come along, we naturally focus on the great accomplishments of those athletes that get there, but we must never forget that so many fantastic gymnasts, world-class gymnasts, do not get to attend. They just miss out marginally. Nina Derval of Belgium, the reigning Olympic champion on the uneven bars, but going for qualification on beam. She won in Cairo. She had surgery in the second half of last year to deal with a shoulder injury. And she's one of the athletes for whom the qualification pathways have narrowed because of her being unable to attend the World Championships. She certainly would have been a real favourite to gain a qualification berth one way or the other. That was nice and stable. Wolf turns well performed. She employs the twisting gainer dismount in the pike position to conclude her display. Nina Derval of Belgium had some difficulties at the beginning, But what great gymnasts do, and goodness knows she is a great gymnast, is they manage to find a way to minimise that difficulty. She makes light of that. Many, many athletes would have gone off the apparatus there. And there the Steingruber dismount.
Insofern
habe ich höchsten Respekt davor. 13.433 for Nina Dörwal. She's actually done really well to keep it to within a few tenths of her qualification score. James Bacquetti of Australia. Eighth in qualification, but he has two difficult vaults, 5.6. He's going to begin, by the looks of things, with Marian Dragulescu's vault. Yes, nicely done. James Bacquetti. Bronze medalist at the Commonwealth Games in Birmingham. He's been a continental champion as well. Gets good height. Loses a little of the tidiness of form, perhaps, in the final stages of the vault. But there's no doubting his power, his ability to handle a vault of that difficulty. He has been a World Cup medalist on vault. Execution wise, just a fraction down by hundredths from qualification. It does well there, doesn't he? Double twisting Casamatsu vault, named after the great Eric Lopez, four-time Pan American Games all-around champion over a remarkably dominant 12-year spell. Good performance this from James Bacquetti. You do have to love the way he's breaking into a smile and a chuckle as he comes back up and realizes that he's got through that. He's a very strong gentleman in terms of his ability to write something, to hold on to something. Now that is a real improvement in terms of the second vault. 14.533 over 2/10 gained from qualification. So he is fourth at the moment. This is Algeria's Kelly Nemour. who has been the talk of the town since she achieved that brilliant gold medal with a 7.0 difficulty on the uneven bars yesterday. A gymnast whose composure and confidence are remarkable, and a gymnast who has already qualified for the Olympic Games due to finishing 8th in the world in the all-around competition in Antwerp at the last World Championships. Just developing across the board in such a strong way, Kelly Nimmore. We talk about her uneven bars work with just cause, but the way that she is progressing as an all-rounder is very exciting too. She is the reigning African champion. And certainly, had she not managed to secure an all-around qualification spot at the World Championships in Belgium last year, she would have been a huge contender to take the continental all-around qualification spot at the African Championships. Probably a lot of gymnasts in Africa very relieved that they will have a pathway without her to contend with at the African Championships.
Ja, die Bilder von ihrer Barbie-Belohnung sind wirklich gestern in die ganze Welt gegangen.
It was the first time ever in any International Gymnastics Federation competition yesterday that the Algerian national anthem had played.
C'est un regard de ralenti, ça c'est bien. C'est terrible ralenti pour les gens. Décale bien, c'est pas mal tendu là, tu vois. Lui, il est réfléchi. La hanche est ouverte, tu vois, un peu bas. Elle monte un petit poil la hanche.
14 is the score for Kaylee Nimmore. She was the second best in qualification. That is 0.133 below her qualifying score. She's third now. We go to a very interesting gymnast on vault, Zhengwei Sheng of Chinese Taipei. He was the seventh best in qualification. Silver medalist at the World University Games in Chengdu. Now he has got room to improve his execution with this first vault compared to the preliminary round. And he is unlikely to do so, unfortunately. Certainly went out of bounds. Flag is up. He had 0.1 for penalty marks in the qualification stage two. It's not the most tight of pike positions in the Lou vault. And a jarred landing. If you have a look at the contact that he makes with the landing mat, it's rather a sense, almost that old cliche of the mat meeting him rather than him meeting the mat.
Hat sich dann natürlich noch sehr, sehr gut gerettet. Das spricht für seine Routine. Ja, vorher ist er hier Sechster geworden.
25 now, Tseng. This is the 10th time that he's been in a World Cup final. So the score is down by 6/10 of a mark from qualifying. He is somebody who didn't make the final in Cairo and who is not part of a team that has qualified for the Olympiad. His second vault is being indicated as Jorge Roche's vault. 5.2 difficulty. And that indeed is what we see. What a nice performance that was from Tseng Weisheng. 5.2 Roche. He does judge the angle of landing nicely. Right to be buoyant about that is Tseng Weisheng. Looked very in control. The average score, 14.4 for the second vault, same as qualification. We go to Laura Casabuena of Spain, 8th best in qualifying, 13.133. Immediate reset required for the teenager from the Valencian community in Spain. She won a bronze medal on floor in Cairo. Her first medal in an International Gymnastics Federation competition. Pressure occasion it is for all of these athletes. This is an opportunity to earn a place at Paris 2024, and we cannot, any of us who've never been close to situations like that, even begin to imagine what that does to the psyche of an elite athlete. Holds the dismount well, Laura Casabuena of Spain. Well, this is making for a very interesting qualification picture, because for Nina Derwall it's all very pleasing. The gymnast going for a balance beam spot in this particular final, Williams, Pinkston, Derwall, Casabuena. And so it could well be the case that Nina Derwall comes out of this with two very good finishes.
Ja, kann mir vorstellen, wenn mental wieder reinzukommen und auch körperlich ist es schwierig, wenn man dann abgestiegen ist.
Ja, ist nicht einfach, weil man fängt eben mit dem Sturz an und weiß, du bist hier im
Zeit lief, nochmal gelaufen ist, dann ist alles mal quasi vor Gesicht bekommen. Ja.
War dann eigentlich immer so jemand, ich würde es lieber am liebsten gar nicht sehen.
Aber ich habe es mal ganz genau geguckt, das zu sehen. Ja, das ist alles immer durch den Kopf geht.
Ja, den Doppelsalto gebückt als Abgang. Hat es echt noch gut gemacht, leicht aus der Achse gewesen. Auf die Füße gestellt.
Casabuena has competed at two world championships now. Was an all-around finalist in Liverpool. Calculations continuing.
Absolut. Ja, dann können wir vielleicht die Zeit nutzen, hier noch zwei Teilnehmer zu begrüßen.
Experience amongst those judges, including the familiar figure of Oksana Emiliancik.
Emma Malewski. Hallo Emma.
Herself a three-time champion of the world. 9.6 for Laura Casabuena. So it means that Joya Chin is leading, Ashikawa Urara is second, Nina Derwal is in Kelly Nemour, I should say, is third, Nina Derwal is in fourth position. We have one to go. Arta Davtian is the penultimate gymnast to vault. The 2022 world champion. And the bronze medalist at the Olympic Games. The owner of one of the most delightful Dragulescus that the world has ever seen. There it was. That's the one. Arta Davtian. Excellent in qualification, looking on the job in the final two. That's the goal for them all. And he's already got a place due to the all-around performance he produced at the World Championships. For him, that might be very slightly more piked than it sometimes is. One is always splitting hairs with Arta Davtian, but in terms of the stability of the landing, I mean, it is peerless. It's that sense of control that one gets from him. He's already won 8 gold medals in World Cup competition. He had a spell of winning 6 World Cup titles in a row on vault, and he won in Cairo last week. 15.1, that'll do nicely. He's up 0.2 from qualifying. Of his vaults, 5.6 in difficulty. He's somebody who is not put off by the challenge of those who have a 5.6 and a 6.0. He goes for the crispness of execution. And that is well executed too. Now, what will be interesting is to see where this features in comparison to Mario Fatti, who is leading on 14.9. There's a bit of a landing adjustment from Arta Davtian. But his mid-air form, as ever, is strong. Will he just nudge in front of the Iranian gentleman?
Und
Yes, he will. 15.05. Arthur Davtian. He's ahead by just over a tenth. 15 for the second vault. To Nakamura Haruka of Japan, the reigning all-around junior world champion, a wonderful young gymnast from the city of Osaka in Shiga Prefecture. Beautiful wolf turns. Side somersault with a little instability coming out of it, disguised well, controlled well. Nakamura Haruka, this is a young athlete of substance, of quality. How exciting a prospect she is for the Japanese national team. She's one that the hardcore gymnastics fans have been waiting to see on the senior circuit for quite some time. And you know who you are. You are probably someone I'm talking to right now. You've been following the Japanese championships at junior level for a while. You watched the junior world championships in Antalya last year, and you've been waiting to see what impact she has on the Japanese squad. A lot of the athletes that are newer seniors at this stage are thinking realistically about an Olympic Games in 4 years' time in Los Angeles, but there's always somebody who makes their way unexpectedly into the national team right as the Games approaches due to suddenly finding form. Sometimes it's those first-year seniors who unexpectedly make a charge for the squad. Wow, she's won a medal. Welcome to the senior circuit, Nakamura Haruka. Now we go to the last contender in this vault competition. Individual neutral athlete Igor Sharamkov. Third best in qualification, he's a contender here. Just needs this to be a little sharper from an execution point of view. Interesting. Both of his vaults, 5.6 difficulty, so on a par with those at the top of the leaderboard. One of several who's employed the vault created by a Olympic medalist in 1996, Yo Hongchul.
Wir sehen ja Schmier nochmal wohnig und wahrscheinlich gleich noch ein bisschen Magnesium auf seine Hände für den besseren Griff am Tisch, nehme ich an, oder?
Ja, dann stützt der Stuhl genau gegen den Tisch und damit man da nicht rüberrutschen kann, ist natürlich besser, wenn man klebt, aber dass es nicht schwierig ist. Also deswegen natürlich die Mischung aus
14.7 for each vault in qualification. It's Davtian, then Olfati, then Chun.
Is
what's required to get onto the podium. So he has got to make an improvement from the preliminary round.
Vor den Kräften, die auftreten, müssen zu schonen.
So, wir schauen, welche Kräfte aufgetreten sind. Haben wir sehen, wie die Wertung aussieht.
14.5. Down by 2/10 of execution.
Nummer 2, Julius Licht.
Dragulescu vault, second. That again was well performed. It may well be that Igor Shadomkov just fractionally misses out. It's going to be quite tight at the top of the leaderboard. From a landing point of view, he's a little piked, has a small shuffle, but it's a powerful vault, and it's a secure vault. He has been a medalist at the European Championships on vault and at the World University Games. His score is 14.566. It actually has him in sixth position in the end. And that means that it is Artur Davtian who takes it ahead of Mahdi Olfati, ahead of Chun Yi Lu. As is customary in Cottbus, we'll give you some interval entertainment now. A little hip hop for your enjoyment. appreciated by the crowd in the Lausitz Arena, and I'm sure by you watching at home. Nice to have a little diversion from the pressures of Olympic qualification. And we always see great work from these young gymnasts. They always follow the dancers. We had some rhythmic gymnasts yesterday who did very well, and then the young gentlemen. Good luck to them. Have a great time and enjoy every moment here. Who knows which of these we might be seeing in a Cottbus World Cup final in years to come. Jolly well done to them. Great platform at this World Cup always for young gymnasts. And there's such a rich tradition in Germany of gymnastics clubs. We move now to a key piece of business, the awarding of medals. Time for the victory ceremony in the women's balance beam competition at the Cottbus 2024 World Cup, part of the Paris 2024 qualification process. A new name at senior level is Nakamura Haruka, the reigning junior all-around world champion, and she is a senior international medalist. Immediately, she's joined by her more senior teammate, 5 years older than her and already a champion of the world, Ashikawa Urara. Finishes second behind the runner-up at the last World Championships, Joy Yachin of the People's Republic of China, who set the tone for a most engrossing final with a brilliant starting performance of 14.9. And we will now have the national anthem of the People's Republic of China. Medalists in the women's balance beam competition at the Cottbus 2024 World Cup.
Barracuda Nakamura. Die drei besten am Biken beim 47. Turnier der Meisterkonferenz. Das ist euer Applaus. So schön, dass wir uns nicht mehr auf die letzten drei Jahre mit dem Lauf die Herren haben ihre Medaille verdient und wir kommen nun zur nächsten Siegerin.
The victory ceremony for the men's vault competition in Cottbus. Chen Yilu of the People's Republic of China, the winner of the bronze medal, the 26-year-old who's been the national champion. He's a pleasure to see at international level. What a great result this is for Mahdi Olfati of the Islamic Republic of Iran. He was fifth in Cairo. He needed a big display today and he absolutely delivered it. But it is one of the finest in the world over the last several years, Arda Davtian, who wins the title. It is his ninth World Cup gold medal. He won in Cairo last week. And he is the World Cup champion from last year and from the year before. And he might well win it again in 2024. Medalists in the men's vault competition at the Cottbus World Cup. Very close final it was too. On we go to the next set of finals. We've got the men's parallel bars and the women's floor to come. The classified results in the men's vault competition. Chen Yilu of China winning bronze, Mahdi Olfati of Iran winning silver, and Arda Davtian of Armenia taking the title. The final standings in the balance beam competition with Zhou Yachin of the People's Republic of China finishing ahead of two gymnasts from Japan, Ashikawa Urara and Nakamura Haruka. The women's floor finalist, Abby Martin of Great Britain, the reigning junior British, English and Welsh champion, Kaylin Amour of Algeria, Aida Barijanova of Kazakhstan, the reigning Islamic Solidarity Games champion on floor, Floor Slauf of the Netherlands, medalist at the OSIEC World Cup last year. Sevgi Kayasoglu of Turkey, medalist at the Islamic Solidarity Games. Zhou Yachin of the People's Republic of China, who's the reigning Chinese champion on floor. Chen Xinyi of the People's Republic of China, the reigning national champion. And Charlize Murz of Austria, champion on floor at national level. Oleg Vanyaev will start the parallel bars final. He was the second best qualifier and he was the Olympic champion in 2016. This is Angel Barajas of Colombia, a star performer, the junior world champion on this piece. Ilya Kovtun of Ukraine, European champion. We have Coy Young of the United States of America, who was a brilliant performer at the World Championships in Antwerp. Kawakami Shohei of Japan, medalist at the World University Games and Asian Games. Hung Yuan Si of Chinese Taipei, medalist at Asian Championship level. Josimar Calvo of Colombia, who has 35 gold medals across Pan-American competition. And Rasuljon Abdurahimov of Uzbekistan, who competed at the Olympic Games and was 24th on parallel bars. The finalists in the women's floor competition, the top performer in qualification, China's Joy Yachin, who's looking for two gold medals in a row today. Second best was her own teammate, Chun Qingyi, by a single tenth, 13.6 to 13.5. Close to them was the third best in qualification, who'll be last to go, Charlize Mertz of Austria, 13.2. The men's parallel bars final. We'll see Oleg Vanyaev and Ilya Kovtun, both of Ukraine, performing as the top two qualifiers, with Kovtun the winner in Cairo. Both of them part of a Ukraine team that has qualified for the Olympiad, so they are not concerning themselves with parallel bars qualification for the Games. For the likes of Angel Barajas of Colombia, Hung Yuan Si of Chinese Taipei, Josimar Calvo also of Colombia, and Rasuljon Abdurahimov of Uzbekistan, this is very much an Olympic qualification event for them. For Vanyaev, Kovtun, Coy Young and Kawakami Shohei, it's a different ballgame. They are part of teams that have qualified. Let's just look at that situation in the women's floor final as well. Abby Martin, Floor Slof, Joy Yachin, Chun Qingyi are all part of teams that have qualified for the Olympics. Kellyanne Moore has qualified as an all-rounder. That leaves us really focusing from an Olympic qualification point of view on Aida Balijanova of Kazakhstan. She'll go third. Sevgi Kayasolu of Turkey, she'll go fifth. And Charlize Mertz of Austria, she will go eighth. Apologies if I am bombarding with Olympic qualification information. I'm doing my level best to try and keep you abreast of the whole situation. It is a complicated thing, isn't it? But it's all worth it to get opportunities for these gymnasts to get to Paris 2024. And I suspect I speak for all of you watching when I say good luck to the lot of them. We wish them a good competition, a good season, good health going into the running for Paris, because there's nothing worse than when an athlete misses out on the chance to qualify due to injury or illness. You just want everyone to have a chance, don't you? A level playing field. She's one of the new ones on the international scene. Bright prospect for the British team. Made the vault final yesterday. As we're talking about bright young prospects, there we see an American who was stunning at the World Championships last year, who's only 21.
Und damit ist das Eigentor beendet. Wir haben grünes Licht für die Bodenübung der Damen für Großbritannien, Abigail Martin.
Abby Martin of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, fourth best in qualification on floor. Great Britain's Abby Martin, finalist on floor at the Junior World Championships in Antalya last year, where she was also fifth in the all-around competition. Layout work in her routine. She's a gymnast whose confidence has grown as a result of her performance at the Junior World Championships. And her profile has really grown internationally as well, justifiably. Respected young athlete. She's been with the South Devon School of Gymnastics since she was 5 years old. Abby Martin, club based in Paignton in the southwest of England. 12.966 is very close to her performance in qualification, down by only a tenth. We go to one of the great performers in years gone by on the parallel bars, the champion at the Olympic Games in Rio in 2016, Oleg Vernyaev, and he still is capable of producing beautiful work on this apparatus. He was the runner-up in Cairo last week. He still is only 29. Nice dismount from Oleg Vernyaev. I was a little kind on him at the start with his age. He is 30. It was his birthday right in the second half of last year. So apologies for that. World champion back in 2014 on the parallel bars, Oleg Vernyaev. Six was the difficulty score in qualification. And work on the single rail, and then it just lost its position. It seemed to be completely secure at the start. Right. 15.166. It is better from an execution point of view than qualifying. That was the same score that Ilya Kovtun got in qualification. Kelly Namur, sixth best in qualification. Nigeria's Kellyanne Moore. In three finals over the course of this weekend, and already guaranteed a place at Paris 2024. She is a great fan of artistic sport beyond her own. She watches figure skating, really enjoys it, as I know many of you do as fans of the sport. Difficulty score of 5.0 in qualification, 12.833 overall, 12.866 this time, so she is just behind Abby Martin. This will be very interesting to see Angel Barajas. The 17-year-old from Cucuta in the northeast of Colombia on the Venezuelan border, junior champion of the world on this apparatus. What a lovely steady handstand. Maintaining his form. And to fight to hold that good core strength. Just maybe a little loss of the foot form there. Wasn't enormously tidy, but he's recovered well. Babsar looks good. And his dismount is nice as well. He's a very interesting young gymnast, Angel Barajas. Won the bronze medal on the horizontal bar in Cairo. Fifth best in qualification for this final. This is so much more secure a display than we saw in the final in Cairo, where he scored only 10.566. For Angel Barajas, he's up from qualification. Goes into second place, but for how much longer? Because Ilya Kovtun's next. Now to Kazakhstan's Aida Baruzhanova. Really experienced athlete, 26 from Nur-Sultan. Eighth best in qualification. She is going for Olympic qualification through this route. reigning Islamic Solidarity Games champion on floor, Aida Barijanova of Kazakhstan. She's competed at 3 Asian Games, 4 World Championships, and the World University Games as well. And a very engaging performer on floor. She has been for a number of years in World Cup competition. Nice sense of flourish coming out of the pike landing, or the pike position into the landing. A little bit of oscillation in the wolf turns. Choreographically, it has poise. She has a degree in coaching from the Eurasian National University in Kazakhstan. She is in third position. Now, Ilya Kovtun of Ukraine, top performer in qualification, the champion in Cairo, and the World Cup overall winner on parallel bars last year. He won the European title on this apparatus too in 2023, his first major international title. Good Diamandov work. Little arch of the back, but so much strength in the handstand on the single rail. In extra rotations of the body where others don't, to accumulate that very high difficulty score. Controlled the overarch well there, disguised it. He's capable of scoring well into the 15s, Ilya Kovtun. A good marker has been laid down by his more experienced teammate, 10 years older, Oleg Vanyaev, on 15.166. But the high scoring potential for Kovtun is never in doubt. He is one away from 20 gold medals in World Cup and World Challenge Cup competition. Ilya Kovtun has gone into the lead by a single tenth over Oleg Vanyaev. Is it beatable? Such a high number. Floor Slof of the Netherlands, seventh best in qualification. All-around bronze medalist at the Dutch Championships last year. Thank you. a couple of really tricky tumbling passes there, Floorsloaf, and showed excellent strength in rescuing them as best she could. The Dutch have qualified a team to Paris 2024. Floorsloaf has been a medalist on floor at World Challenge Cup level. That's where she could so easily have slipped and gone down into a seated position. Held it very well. Lack of symmetry in the backed up position. And that contributed perhaps to an unsteady looking landing. Still just 17, developing her international experience all the time. Continuing to show plenty of promise, Floorsloaf.
And
12.366. So she is down by just under half a mark from qualification. Coy Young of the United States of America. 21 and a winner of three medals at the World Championships, his debut World Championships last year. Very, very fine young gymnast. And an undergraduate at Stanford University. American delegation providing their own running commentary, as they always do, supporting each other so well. Comes into a mighty Bavzar. Into the Tippelts. To a good handstand. Has to steady himself for the dismount, which he's a little displeased about, but goodness me, he's an interesting young athlete, is Coy Young. The first American man since the late great Kurt Thomas and the also great Bart Connor to win multiple individual apparatus medals at a single world championship. Was the qualification score 14.133 in the final. Execution down a little. The landing will certainly have contributed to that in some substance. And that brings us to the halfway stage of these two finals. Just the men's horizontal bar final remains after this. This is where we are at the moment in the floor competition. Abby Martin of Great Britain is the leader. We have the top three qualifiers, though, all to come in the second half of the final. On the parallel bars, no great surprise that it's the Ukrainian duo that are at the top of the standings. From a Paris 2024 perspective, Barajas well positioned, but we have yet to see Hung Yuan Si, Josimar Calvo, and Rasuljon Abdurakhimov. So the Paris 2024 picture is going to get more clear as the final enters the second half. For the women, Sevgi Kayesolo is next. She is going for Paris qualification, will be looking to finish above Barijanova, and based on qualification she can do that. Are things set up for Charlize Mertz to be the top performer of the Paris 2024 hopefuls? She'll be the last to go, and she scored 13.2 in the preliminary round. Those are the Turkish men's squad watching on. Very happy Turkiye in terms of the men's team, for they managed to qualify a full team for Paris 2024 for the first time ever. It's extraordinary the way that gymnastics has developed, particularly on the men's side in that country. Can Sevgi Kayesolo join the men's team wearing the national colours in Paris? Let's find out. Sevgi Kayesolo of Turkiye, fifth best in qualification. She didn't make the final in Cairo. Big routine coming up for her. She won her first World Cup title last year, Sevgi Kayesolo, in World Challenge Cup competition in her home event in Mersin, to add to two bronze medals that she already holds. The 18-year-old from Bolu in the northwest of the country. She's always been a gymnast who employs distinctive choreography to her work. She's had some really exciting routines over the years. She feels, when you watch her, very at home on floor. That was right near the end, where there was an uncomfortable looking moment that she salvaged impressively. Just a loss of equilibrium. Now 12.933 in qualification. Barijanova 12.733. And Kayesolo is ahead of her, 12.833. Sevgi Kayesolo, in her Olympic qualification quest, is down a tenth from qualifying, but she's well positioned at the moment. This is Kawakami Shohei, of Japan. He's only 20. He's from Ehime in Shikoku Island, right down in the southwest of the main archipelago. It's only his second World Cup competition. Good travel on his Bavzar. Little overarch is costly though. Dismount. He set himself for that beautifully with a really tight man of position. Lovely conclusion from Kawakami Shohei, team silver medalist at the World University Games and the Asian Games last year. He was fourth in the all-around competition in Hangzhou at the Asian Games. He was not happy with himself, said he honestly expected that he would be stronger. He's a very ambitious youngster. This is really good work. It's 14 and a half, the qualification score. And he's up 14.666, not quite enough to go beyond Angel Barajas. Just remind you that the Japanese have qualified a team anyway for the games. Zhou Yachin of the People's Republic of China, sixth to go on floor. She's already won the gold on beam, and she was the top performer in floor qualification with 13.6. She is the reigning Chinese champion. It really does connect choreography and orchestration, that routine from Zhou Yachin. Sense of harmony with the music. And some big pirouetting as well. Yes, something of a lunge coming out of it, but it contributes to good difficulty. She had the second highest difficulty of all qualifiers.
Hier die starke Bahn mit dreifach Schraube rückwärts,
That sort of directional change tumbling as well is really impressive. Legs going up towards horizontal there, if not there, then thereabouts. Oh, 13.6 in qualification and 8.1 for execution. Difficulty we've seen so far is Abby Martin. There will be a bit of a deduction there for that over rotation and the adjustment step that came with it. Two to go after this. Next is Chun Xinyi. 13.533. She does lead. The difficulty is lower than in qualification by a tenth, and it may well be that is what is provoking some discussion. We'll come back to that. This is Hung Yuan Si of Chinese Taipei, 22-year-old who competes at the Olympic Games at very short notice as an injury replacement alternate. Unfortunately, is really problematic for a gymnast who didn't make the final in Cairo, and for somebody who is aiming for Olympic qualification through this route. There is still a path open to gymnasts at the Continental Championships, but things start to become very limited the closer that one gets to Paris 2024. He did very well to stay on there. That was tricky. Another little reset going into handstand. Small reset contributing to the execution deductions. But there is ever so much about this young athlete that is lovely to watch. Dismount evidence of it. He is an undergraduate in international business at the Taipei University of Business. Comes from something of a gymnastics family. One could only imagine how he felt being called into action 4 days before the Olympic Games after a teammate was injured. That's where he did incredibly to hold an overarched handstand. Very precise in the trajectory of the landing. Double front tuck, spot on. Mit 13.466, it is 1.2 down from qualification for obvious reasons. Much more difficult display in the final in terms of the skills he put in. Now to Chen Xinyi. We've had the Chinese champion on floor. This is the winner of the title of the Chinese individual championships in the same year. So they are both Zhou Yaqin and Chen Xinyi, effectively Chinese champions on this apparatus. And they were separated by a single tenth in qualification. Chen was the lower, 13.6 to 13.5. Another routine with such a strong degree of difficulty by comparison to what we've seen so far in this final. The two Chinese athletes, Zhou Yaqin and Chen Xinyi, upping the stakes in terms of tumbling work. Now, has Chen Xinyi done enough to go ahead of her teammate and reverse the standings from qualification? Still only 16, Chen. About a year and a half younger than Zhou. And a senior international debut this as well. What an impressive one it was, what a composed one, what a precise one. Jo leads on 13.533, she's guaranteed a medal. Chun finishes above Abby Martin. And she is also guaranteed to win a medal. Only one athlete is left, and it's Charlize Mertz of Austria.
Man zwischendurch mal unterbrechen müsste, weil so viel Konzentration am Schluss kann man einfach niemandem nachfallen. Es ist höchstens hier an der Stelle der Zeichen, die Wertung tatsächlich auf die Beine zu bringen und zu gucken, was genau wurde denn da gemacht und wie genau.
Vielleicht ein kleiner Fehler unterlaufen. Das
Zeit dann schon auch mal einen Einspruch gibt, eben wie bei den zwei Turnerinnen davor. Und dann muss da nochmal genau hingeschaut werden, eine Videoanalyse gemacht werden, wird nochmal wirklich jedes Element einzeln durchgegangen und auch nochmal in Slow Motion geschaut, wirklich, wirklich Bild für Bild, ob vielleicht der Fuß rum ist, ob das Element gezählt wird oder nicht, sind es über 180 Grad Spreizwinkel oder nicht. Und da, man hat es dann schon nicht
immer ganz longer wait this for a score to come in on floor. Much deliberation going on, and frankly that's absolutely fine. Let the judges take the time it takes them, because their responsibility is a great one when it's an Olympic qualification event. We wish them the best of fortune in getting it right. It's a pressure occasion for these judges too, and they are vital, absolutely vital to this process for accuracy and for fairness across all four of the World Cups. Their burden is a heavy one. Now, I think what's going on there is that there's been a change to Sevgi Kayasolo's score.
Die Chinesin ist auch akzeptiert worden und ihr D-Wert wurde um 2 Zehntel hoch erhöht von 5,4 auf 5,6.
So that's why the process was taking a while. Right, we'll come back to that in a moment. 13.666 for Chun Xinyi. Meanwhile, Joya Chin has gained 2/10 of difficulty. We did notice, I'm sure notice as well, the reaction from the Chinese coaching staff when that score came in. And also Sevgi Kayasolo's score has gone up by a tenth as well. I'll just update you again on all of that after this performance from veteran Josimar Calvo of Colombia. He was the third best in qualification with a 6.7 difficulty score. He could get up close to these leaders. Won the bronze medal in Cairo. That's nice. Oh, a shame that the handstand went astray. Oh, that was just a little too explosive in its power. Came off the end. He really did go for it, didn't he? Josimar Calvo from the same part of Colombia as his young teammate Angel Barajas. His dismount is lovely. That was such a fine routine, except for that crucial loss of contact, the unintentional dismount from the apparatus costing him a full mark. We just remind ourselves of the rules here that only one place per nation is available on each apparatus. There are two spots in total on the parallel bars, but they cannot be won by two Colombians. Calvo did perform well in Cairo, winning the bronze medal. So he has got a little breathing space, if you will, but 13.366, not the number he was hoping for. We We go to the last performer on floor, Charlize Mertz of Austria, third best in qualification. She's never won World Cup honours. Issue right at the end there, didn't she, Mertz, coming out of the pirouette, but there was some quality tumbling on show from the 18-year-old from Eisenstadt in the far east of Austria. She's competed at three world championships, this great young gymnast from Austria who's been a prospect for them for some time. She's the daughter of a very fine midfielder in football who was an international competitor and the top goal scorer in the Austrian Cup actually in 2005-2006. One of three Mertz sisters in gymnastics. No Austrian woman has ever won a medal in the current format of these four Big Four World Cups. Last Austrian honours were a silver medal on floor from Marlies Mennersdorfer at the Osijek World Challenge Cup in 2021. And in 2010 there was a medal for Barbara Gasser on the uneven bars, also in Osijek, but that was before the current format of the competition. And my thanks to a very fine gymnastics statistician in Brazil who pulled that one out of the dusty archives for me. I take no credit for it. She's a very accomplished tumbler, is Mertz. 5.6 was the difficulty score in qualification. She was fourth on the tiebreak criteria, Mertz, in Cairo. She has a medal! She has a medal! 13.1! Charlize Mertz, it's brilliant from her own perspective of a first time ever on a World Cup podium, but also from an Olympic qualification standpoint, that's an excellent result. Charlize Mertz becomes the first Austrian woman to win a medal in the present format of the Big Four World Cups. Rasuljon Abdurakhimov of Uzbekistan is last to go on the parallel bars, and he delivers some very accomplished work on this piece. He was sixth in Cairo. Can he go better here? He was the fourth best qualifier, so it might well be the case, especially after the door has been opened by a few others. He's pacey, isn't he? lovely, silky smooth. Then a little shudder. Very nice straddle front. That was defined, deliberate and delicate from Rasuljon Abdurakhimov of Uzbekistan. And already an Olympian from Tokyo. He received a medal called the Builder of the Future medal from the president after his performance at the Olympic Games, the Kalayak Bunyodkori honor. He's always spoken so warmly of his uncle's influence, how much he wants to make him proud. It was his uncle who brought him into the world of gymnastics. This is the fourth time he's been in a World Cup final. Fifth is his best result. ...14.733, currently occupies bronze, that's Angel Barajas. That's exactly the score that Abdurakhimov got in qualification, so he could be in for a really intriguing finish here. Abdurakhimov's execution was the best of any qualifier for the final. So one often backs him to win an execution tiebreak. This is the last score to come in. It's Kovtun, Vanyaev and Barajas. Barajas and Abdurakhimov going head to head from a Paris 2024 perspective. And Abdurakhimov has got him. 14.766 by a few hundreds. He takes his first ever World Cup honours. Ahead of the teenager, he's on the podium. The classified results in the floor competition. Big result for Charlies Mertz of Austria, winning the bronze medal and positioning herself well after she was fourth in Cairo. Classified results in the men's parallel bars competition. Kovtun and Vanyaev at the top of the leaderboard. Abdurakhimov, key performer from an Olympic qualification perspective. Hats off to him. Hats on for them. you suspect that they will always remember that moment. And it's so important, isn't it, to give young athletes a showcase, to give them a chance to aspire to something. Because yes, they get to perform. Yes, they get to lead out gymnasts. They also get to watch the gymnastics. They get to see what the future is like. And they get to dream of being center stage, not just as intermediary acts, but when the scores are being awarded. Good luck to all of those youngsters. The victory ceremony in the women's floor competition in Cottbus. Charlize Mertz of Austria, the bronze medalist. 13.1 her score, a very important one. It propels her onto an international podium for the first time and is a great result for her dreams of going to Paris 2024. Above her, Chun Xinyi, a senior international debut to remember. She is the silver medalist, bested only by her own teammate, Joy Yachin. Two gymnasts who won titles on floor at national level last year, bringing that work to the global stage. And as a result, we will hear in just a moment or two the national anthem of the People's Republic of China. There they are, the medalists in the women's floor competition at the Cottbus 2024 World Cup of Artistic Gymnastics. All of them on an international podium for the first time. Two folk here who certainly aren't on an international podium for the first time. One of them, who has won World Cup gold number 20. The victory ceremony for the men's parallel bars competition at the Lausitz Arena in Cottbus, Germany. Welcome to the World Cup podium, Rasuljon Abdurakhimov of Uzbekistan. Fourth time he's made a final, and this is a big result for the Olympic hopeful. Oleg Vanyaev, who's been a champion at the Olympics on this apparatus, narrowly takes second place behind his teammates, just as was the case in Cairo a week ago. It's Kovtun again. The man who is virtually unbeatable at World Cup level on this piece. That is gold medal number 20 for him in World Cup competition, and he's only 20. He is absolutely going to be a force to be reckoned with on this apparatus at the Olympic Games. the medalists in the parallel bars competition at the Cottbus World Cup. And we have just one more final left now. Catch a glimpse in the foreground of the great photographer Volker Minkus, who is hugely experienced in capturing the finest moments in gymnastics competitions. And he was a very good parallel bars gymnast in his day as well, Mr. Minkus. Now to the men's horizontal bar final. So Tang Chiahong of Chinese Taipei, top qualifier, then Joel Plater, fourth best in qualification, the Spaniard. Tyson Bull of Australia, eighth best. Miwa Tepe, I should say, of Japan, seventh best. Chan Hao of the People's Republic of China, second strongest in qualifying. Robert Torregan of Lithuania, the fifth best. Bart Derla of the Netherlands, the third best. And the sixth best, Arthur Nori Mariano of Brazil. This is the last event of the Cottbus World Cup. Hope you're enjoying it all so far and are looking forward to this men's high bar final. It's been great to have you with us throughout the weekend. The finalists in the men's horizontal bar competition in Cottbus, the first gymnast to go, Tang Chiahong of Chinese Taipei, was the strongest performer in qualification. We really have a decorated field here. This should be fascinating. Well, let's have a look at the contenders. Tang Chiahong, the winner in Cairo, and a gymnast who is going for Olympic qualification via this route. The Asian Games champion from 2018 and the World University Games champion from 2019. The Spaniard Joel Plater is warming up on the apparatus now. He represents a team that has already qualified, ergo he is not an applicable Olympic qualifier through this route. And would be expected to Joel Plater to be an important part of that Spanish team. Both Tang and Plater have competed at the Olympic Games, as has the gymnast who is warming up now, Tyson Bull of Australia. He was fifth on this apparatus at the Olympiad. Just missed out on the World Championship final last year. And he didn't make the final in Cairo. He is going for Olympic qualification via this route. And that leaves us with the last gentleman in the first half. Miwa Tepe of Japan, not attempting to qualify for the Olympics via this route because the Japanese already have a team place secured. Therefore, he's not eligible. The teams who have qualified in the men's competition, China, Japan and Great Britain, they won their places at the 2022 World Championships, and then last year in Antwerp it was the USA, Canada, Germany, Italy, Switzerland, Spain, Turkey, the Netherlands and Ukraine who added their names to make up the 12 strong team quota. He was part of the Chinese Taipei team in Tokyo and was seventh in the all-around competition. but now needs to take a different approach. Tang Xiaheng of Chinese Taipei, top qualifier, winner in Cairo. Can he make it 2 out of 2? Big giant to begin. Casina. Oh yes, full twisting Yamawaki. Straight Kachev. Piked variation. Goes into a very big conclusion to his routine. Super from Tang Xiaheng of Chinese Taipei. Thought he was going to come right through the TV screen there. Let's have a look back at this big performance to start. All smiles at the moment, Tang Xiaheng. Good work over the first two World Cups from him. The title that he took in Cairo last week, his first World Cup gold since 2017, 14.6. Same as qualification, where he was the finest. That's going to be hard to beat. Very well done to him. Now to Joel Plata of Spain. The fourth best in qualification, 14.233. We've just seen a 14.6. Spanish team already destined for the games. And he goes for that Casina. Straddle Kachev looked quite smooth. Mount on the tidier side. Overall, that performance from Joel Plata. He has one World Cup medal. It was a bronze one in 2018. Gosh, he had a dreadful, dreadful injury last year. And it was nothing to do with gymnastics. Well, he was on his way to a gymnastics competition, but it was a a vehicle accident. Broke his thigh. Awful injury to undergo. It's amazing that he was able to come back in time for the World Championships. One-tenth down from qualification, but the difficulty up by two-tenths, so some positives there for Joel Platter. Tyson Bull of Australia, 30 from Melbourne in Victoria, and fifth at the Olympic Games in Tokyo. He didn't make the final in Cairo. He is endeavouring to qualify through this route for Paris 2024. He gets through his casino and into the Coleman. Mighty straddle Katchev into the pike. Katchev, oh, he's come off. Really working hard to connect the two elements. That is very, very tricky for Tyson Bull, who didn't have much in the way of margin for error after what happened in Cairo. And he's such an exciting performer on this piece. In full flow, he is a joy to watch. So good at the start. So unfortunate that that Katchev combination led to him unintentionally dismounting. He's a very assiduous, hard-working athlete. He won the silver medal at the Commonwealth Games in Birmingham. He was also a medalist at the 2011 Commonwealth Youth Games. And it is one of the more enjoyable and obscure gymnastics events, that the Commonwealth Youth Games. And I shall give you a special honourable points, house points, shall we say, if you're able to name where those Commonwealth Youth Games happened in 2011. And even more if you can tell me who was the all-around men's champion. I'll give you a moment to contemplate that one. Your heart goes out for all of the gymnasts who, as the qualification process goes on, see their path narrowing. It only adds to the pressure. 12.6 for Tyson Bull. The answer to my earlier question, it was the Isle of Man, the 2011 Commonwealth Youth Games, and the all-around champion, Dom Cunningham. Miwa Tepe of Japan. seventh best in qualification. Graduate of the famous Juntendo University that's produced so many Olympic champions in so many sports. Oh, that was a quick-looking Cassina. My, my, my. Coleman as well, very powerful. And the power just eventually meant the control wasn't quite there. It was the straight Kachev that troubled Biwatepe. It's one of the interesting things about the horizontal bar gymnastically. Sometimes when an athlete doesn't make a re-grasp, it's not because of what they've just done, it's because of what happened before. Sometimes the way a gymnast re-grasps can make the bar really tremble. Sometimes they re-grasp and it's very precise and the bar doesn't move much. Sometimes they're left then trying to grip hold of a moving bar. You could see there, I'm sure, that when he went for that second catch, the bar was virtually still. Other times there's a sense of unpredictability to the way the bar behaves as the gymnast's hands are coming back into contact with it. Swiss with power and purpose. Accuracy not fully there from Miwatepe. He is from Shizuoka Prefecture, which is famous for its motorsports, and he is a young man with quite an engine in his work on the horizontal bar, Miwatepe. A lot of horsepower. So that brings to a close the first half of this men's horizontal bar final. Just waiting for the score for Miwatepe. It's 12.833. So he's in third position. We have got the second and third strongest qualifiers to come. So let's take stock of who we're about to see. Tianhao of the People's Republic of China. Leading at the moment is Tang Chiahong on 14.6. Joel Platter is second. There's quite a gap between second and third. Four gymnasts remain. Tianhao, who's already warmed up, second best in qualification. Part of a Chinese team that has already qualified, so not aiming for Olympic qualification. Robert Tvorogal of Lithuania. He will be looking to qualify through this route. He was fifth in Cairo. Mark Durlo of a Dutch team that has qualified a team and who has already competed at the Olympic Games. He was the first Dutch man to reach the all-around final. The seventh on this piece in Tokyo too. Then Arthur Nori Mariano. The Brazilian situation is quite interesting because Brazil has secured an individual non-nominative or non-named place. We'll come back to that later. Tianhao, the People's Republic of China. second in qualification, 14.566. And he is the reigning Asian champion on the horizontal bar. Won the title in Singapore last June. Norman and the casino, the first two release elements. Big straddle catch here, that was nice looking. It's very smooth. Crowd in the Lausitz Arena really enjoyed that. His twisting dismount was good as well. Tian Hao might well get close to Tang Chiahong. Didn't compete in Cairo. He was a couple of tenths higher in difficulty than Tang Chiahong in qualification. Tang posting the same difficulty score in the final, 6.1. So if Tian has managed to get his 6.3 here, which he has done, then I was going to say it could be very close. It is very close. Same score, 14.6. But on the execution tiebreak, it is Tang Chiahong who leads the way. Now to the first ever Lithuanian to win a medal at the European Games in Gymnastics and the European Championships of Artistic Gymnastics. Robert Tvorogal, he was European champion in 2020 on this piece. Fifth in Cairo. Very elegant straight catch if. Working nicely so far. Straddle Kachev into the pike, Kachev. Yes, absolutely. From Robert Tvorogal, who was so disappointed with his performance in Tokyo. At his second Olympic Games, he was thinking about horizontal bar from the start. He said he was thinking too much about it. Struggled in the all-around and ended up finishing 57th in horizontal bar qualification. It's had a tidiness to it. It's a different sort of routine from what we've seen so far. It doesn't have the Kovac variation work, doesn't have a casino in it. It's all about the fundamental Kachev skills. Has the straight straddle and piked variations, including the combination work. He won a silver medal at the European Championships in 2022 in Munich.
Три-три, ёпт.
14.533. His execution, 8.833. He's well up from qualifying by 0.4. Bart Durlo of the Netherlands, 33, just 2 days ago. Bronze medalist at the World Championships in Montreal in 2017 on the horizontal bar. Oh yes, Coleman to Kovac to Cassina. And then a catch ever as well, just to calm us all down. Good powerful pirouette as well. How's this going to look on the dismount? Lovely! Well, I never. Bart Durlo. What combination gymnastics from the veteran. Execution wise, there are clear deductions here, there, possibly everywhere, but the difficulty, I mean, that's just incredible, isn't it? Coleman, Kovac, Cassina, one after t'other. Golly. And the landing. Talk about finishing with a flourish. He did have the highest difficulty score of any qualifier for this final. In news that is not remotely shocking after what you've just seen. How high is it going to be? He scored 14.266 in qualification. His execution was the lowest of all of the qualifiers. Has he managed to push it up a little? Checking and double checking the mathematics. Is nodding. The score may be forthcoming. 14.433. He is up from qualification. Execution wise, it's not quite as strong as some of the other gymnasts. And as a result, he's not going to be on the podium. But it is exciting, isn't it? Interestingly, the difficulty was down 0.2 from qualification. Arthur Nori Mariano of Brazil. Now is the last to go with 14.533, the gatekeeping score on the podium. The world champion from 2019 scored about half a mark less than that in qualification. Kachev to Kachev to Kachev. Straight straddle pike. There is some lovely work from him. always does that full twisting skill so well. Follows it up with the Yamawaki. Oh, he stumbles a little on the dismount. The 30-year-old from São Paulo State. The Brazilian team didn't manage to secure a full squad for Paris 2024, the last World Championships. So their gymnasts now turning attentions to other qualification pathways. They did manage to get some spots at the World Championships for individuals. Tvorogal, 14.6 Tian, 14.6 Tang. That's the top three with this last score to come in. And the last 13.9 for Arta Nori Mariano. He's in sixth position, and it means therefore that Tang Chahong has had an absolutely superb start to Olympic qualification, winning in Cairo and winning here. The gold medal to Tang Chahong of Chinese Taipei on the execution tiebreak ahead of Tian Hao, the People's Republic of China, with Robert Tvorogal of Lithuania taking bronze. As we wait for the victory ceremony, we get to see some of these young gymnasts from their local clubs taking to the same apparatus that medalists of the highest order have just taken to. Very nice, very promising. Well done, that young man. The last medals to be awarded in Cottbus. And a very entertaining men's horizontal bar final it was. As we stare at the rather large bouquet of flowers, there is no ambiguity that it is Tang Chahong who has blossomed over the first half of Olympic qualification. back-to-back titles. Just moments away now from the ceremony. The victory ceremony for the men's horizontal bar competition at the Kopvas World Cup of Artistic Gymnastics, part of the Paris 2024 qualification process. Bronze goes to Robert Tvorogal of Lithuania, the man from Vilnius, who has already been an Olympian on two occasions and who dreams of making it three in a row. Tianhao, the People's Republic of China, wins the silver medal, the Asian champion, only narrowly losing out on an execution tiebreak. Dang Chahong of Chinese Taipei, absolutely superb in Olympic qualification. What a display from him. Gold in Cairo, gold in Cottbus. Giving himself real breathing space with two to go. Amazing to think that that gold medal he won in Cairo last week was his first World Cup title since taking the floor top spot in Doha in 2017. He breathes a sigh of relief. We now hear the anthem of Chinese Taipei. There they are, the medalists in the men's horizontal bar competition in Cottbus. Almost nothing to separate them on the podium. Look at those scores. And as the medalists depart, we depart, but we will return soon for more action in Olympic qualification. Next stop, the shores of the Caspian Sea, Baku, Azerbaijan, on the 9th and 10th of March for stage 3 of 4 in the race to Paris 2024. It's been a great pleasure having your company. I'll say farewell until next we meet.